New developments tonight in an ongoing Call 7 investigation. Chiropractors Brandon and Heather Crater slapped with a cease and desist order. Now the couple's fighting back against the Colorado Medical Board. The Craters coming under scrutiny again by the state following numerous Call 7 investigations exposing dozens of patient complaints and questionable business practices. Call 7 investigator Teresa Marchetta breaking these latest developments.
After settling at least one class action lawsuit with former patients and rebuffing possible sanctions by the chiropractic board, the Craters are about to start round two, stepping back into the ring, or in this case, the administrative courtroom, to face off with the state medical board, this time on charges they're practicing medicine without a license.
Brandon and Heather Crater are chiropractors.
We don't even blink and we collect over $450,000 in a month.
And entrepreneurs. But the state medical board says the couple went too far with their claims and in their treatment of patients. This 12-page notice of charges details what prompted the medical board's cease and desist order against the Craters and their functional endocrinology center.
If anyone told you that I hold myself out to be an endocrinologist, that would be incorrect.
Synthroid actually promotes diabetes.
It says their website, email address, and company name use the terms doctor and physician, but leave out any reference to chiropractic, a point we made several times in our Call 7 investigations, uncovering Crater himself advising chiropractors who want to follow that business model to hide the spines in their offices.
Are you ashamed of being a chiropractor?
And I'd be happy to get you a copy.
But you ask chiropractors to hide the spines in their office?
The notice lists three counts against the couple. Count one, holding one's oneself out to the public as being authorized to practice medicine. Count two, holding oneself out to the public as being able to provide medical services. And count three, maintenance of company website and physical office to provide medical services. We started investigating the Craters nearly 3 years ago, hearing from hundreds of patients who say they paid thousands in cash up front for treatments that didn't work.
And unfortunately, more bad news for the many former patients who have been trying to get their money back from the Craters. On the very same day this notice of charges was filed, the Craters declared bankruptcy. I am dissecting this massive filing, what it reveals about the Craters' lavish lifestyle and the 35 pages of creditors it names. I'm Call 7 investigator Teresa Marchetta.
And if you have a story idea for the Call 7 investigators, call 303-832-7777. You can also send an email to call7@thedenverchannel.com or hit the Tell Us button on the 7 News app.